Kia ora, welcome back to NZOWN. With me, I've got Stella. They just released their best of last week. I've got it right here. I've got Beau and Chris. How are you guys?
Very good, thank you. Thanks
Hello.
For having us.
Welcome along to the show. Now, let's talk about the Stella best of. Like, I mean, when I think about it, three albums and you've got 18 tracks on here. And I was thinking, how can you have, you know, 18 tracks from three albums? But then your first album spawned about, what, five wicked hits?
There's only about two songs out of three that aren't on the best of, but you know.
Yeah, I know. This has a lot of songs on it, and they're basically our favourites. Mm-hmm. They have the hits that people will know, but also I think our particular loves from different albums.
And you've also put in a brand new single as well.
We have a new single on there called So Alive, which is, I don't know, has the Stella-esque sound to it, and we purposely went to the studio and wanted to produce a song that would have those moments that, you know, people would be familiar with, like a bit of a whoa whoa, a bit of a sing-along vibe.
So it's been, what, pretty much 4 years since your last album, and you've been in LA, Beau, and putting out your jewellery. I'd just like to point out this right here. It was a very special birthday present, actually, from my parents, and I haven't taken it off since, so it's probably a bit grubby looking.
Like, just great.
Oh, good.
The more worn they look, the better they are.
A little bit grungy, yeah. So it's been 4 years, so you've been doing your solo thing. You've been producing records, is that right, Chris?
Yeah.
So tell me about your separate identities away from the band.
I've basically been doing like music production and engineering and mixing and things since a long, long time ago.
So, you always have, anyway.
Yeah, even prior to doing the same time as doing the band thing. Last 4 years just got heavily back into that, and I think, and Kurt, the bass player, he's just been working on a solo album. And Andrew does a lot of, do quite a lot of production work with him, and he's does a lot of programming and things like that.
To be honest with you, I haven't done a lot of playing in the last 6 months, really. I've sort of been concentrating on other things. But when I go back after doing these shows, I think I've got to get back into doing music regularly, you know. It's funny because, you know, the jewellery thing takes up quite a lot of time as well, so. Juggling.
Let's talk about the best of. I want you guys to pick a song from this album that, you know, tell me where you were when you wrote it, how you felt about it. Because I suppose best of, you can be a little bit retrospective, introspective.
When I look at a lot of these songs, I think of when we play live, and because we're going to be, you know, revisiting these songs again live. Mm. One for me, which I love, and it's one that wasn't a single, and it's on the first mix album. It's called Nerve and Consequences, which is just a beautiful, moody, lush sounding song, and I actually love singing it. So that's one for me that I really love. I mean, for you, I mean, what do you think?
Mm.
Violence always great as well.
It's a great song to play live.
It's always great,
sure.
A song to play live, and it was a fun song to actually produce because it's super simple, but and incredibly hooky, and it's just been one of those songs that just, I'm really proud of that song, just as far as.
Yeah. I was like, another track of here we love playing live was Slow Burn, which is another track, again, was on mix, wasn't released as a single, but it's got this sort of slow building track, and by the end it's kind of really intense and noisy, and myself and Kurt get to have a good shout BV thing on it, which is good fun, yeah.
Well, let's go on to then, of course you guys are doing Stella, the last shows, and so this is going to be it for you guys, it's your final hurrah?
I never like to say final hurrah.
Possibly the final hurrah.
I'd say more than
90-something percent, probably.
Hurrah.
Until a bit of a reunion, maybe. Until 5 years down the track.
We may never say die, though.
Yeah, it's just going to be a lot of fun. I mean, I think we're playing at Barbadega in Wellington on the 16th. Of October, and we're doing Sail Street on the 21st, and I actually think that's going to be crazy because I've been getting text messages from people going, so coming.
Yeah, it's been interesting, sort of people who, and also a lot of people who didn't actually see us play at the time as well, who I've met since, going, oh, actually, really, I'm going to come and see this.
Yeah.
You know, just the kind of, there's an interest of kind of what it was like, and
yeah. It's a real nostalgia.
Yeah,
a lot of.
And this is for us as well. So it's kind of totally. It's sort of it's viewing it more as just good fun hanging out, as opposed to any other agenda for it. Really, that'd be good.
Righto, well, we'll do another plug for the album. It's Stella, the best of, and we've actually got copies. If you'd like to win, give us an email. It's at mailbox@juicetv.com, and you guys are going to sign a couple of the copies?
Indeed.
Yes.
Okay, so signed by half the band. And we're going to go into a track of yours that I used to love, and it went off live, Violent. So cheers for coming along, guys.
Thank you.